how to cope with stress or burnout, what to do when you're uninspired or unmotivated, or experiences that change your perspective in life. Pretty interesting questions. Let's answer these questions. Okay, this episode will be different from the usual episodes that I do. So for this one, I'll just be reading and answering your comments from my past videos. If you're not into this type of my video, then just check out my past videos or come back again some other time. But for the people who will hang around, I promise to make your time worth it. I just miss interacting with other people, and alam ko naman na this is really nothing compared sa physical conversation talaga with other people, pero with the current situation ngayon, diba? It's a good alternative enough. Plus, in the recent weeks, lahat na lang ng conversation ko with my friends is about the stock market. So, gusto ko naman ng conversation outside personal finance. Okay, for the first question I have, this one is from Jason Tolyong. Kaso yung question niya is, Sir, good PM po. Tanong ko po magkano po binayaran niyo lahat-lahat. So, I think this one is a question kung magkano yung binayaran ko sa Mapua lahat-lahat ng magulang ko. Because this is a comment from my past Mapua video before. So, nung nag-aral ako sa Mapua ng 2010 to 2016, so I took up BSCCE. And yun nga, it took me 6 years, diba? Tapos, yung tuition fee ko before was around 25,000 to 35,000 depende kung meron akong mahal na laboratory classes. So, kunin na lang natin yung average nun. So, average nun is around 30,000. So, it took me, sa Mapua kasi pala muna, you have 4 terms a year. So, yung 30 mo, multiply mo muna by 4. That's 120 times depende kung gano'ng katagal. So, for me, it took me 6 years depende siya kung gano'ng magiging katagal. So, yung 120 times 6, that's 720,000. Yung binayaran ko in my whole stay sa Mapua before ako makagraduate. So, yung 720,000 na yun, that's just all for my tuition fee. Wala pa yung allowances ko, wala pa yung pang books, wala pa yung pang project, wala pa yung pang thesis defense, wala pa yung pang field trip. So, if you want yung total budget, siguro mga around 1 million yung budget na nilaan para sa akin nun. Pero, ano na yun, may buffer na yun. So, more than na yung 1 million sa lahat ng ginastos namin for my academic pag-aaral ko ng buong college. So, yun, that's just a rough estimation. Pero, di ba, yung budget na yun, yung tuition fee na yun, that's way back 2010 to 2016. And, ano na ngayon, it's already 2020. So, I suggest parang tanungin mo ngayon or mag-research ka ngayon ng current tuition fee ng mga nag-aaral ngayon. The next comments na babasahin ko is from Claire Marie Ang. This one is yung buying your first car. So, yung sabi niya dito is, nice content, concise, helpful, unbiased, and honest. Please consider investing on lapel mics in the future so we can better hear the audio. More power. So, for this one, may masasabi na ako. For sure, I'll be investing more in making good content, whether it's increasing yung quality ng storytelling ko, increasing yung production value ng videos ko by buying more gears nga, better gears, or kaya naman by engaging you, the viewers, with more engaging content. So, I'll be parang creating content or, alam mo, parang to be more engaged with you, the viewers. Pero, paano ba? Before I invest more, gusto ko muna sana mag-show tong channel na to ng profitability for me, because even ako, I'm scared na, alam mo, pag kasi adult ka na, once you're investing time and money on something, nakakatakot if it doesn't pay off. So, yun muna, I just want some sort of profitability from this before I invest more in this channel. For now, what I'm committed to myself and you to my community here in this channel is to bring the best content possible with the limited resources that I have as of the moment. Pero what I'm promising is pagka I have gained access to a more or better resources, I promise to increase or deliver a better content experience para sa inyo. The last comments that I will read is from XJoyX. So, she brings good comments. So, thanks for making this video interesting. You have the best questions na sasagutin ko. So, ito yun. Ito yung comment niya. Looking forward to your next content on how to be productive during this quarantine time. Other suggestions would be your recommended inspirational books, how to cope with stress or burnout, what to do when you're uninspired or unmotivated, or experiences that change your perspective in life. With regards to productivity video, I already gave up of making a productivity video kasi ang dami kong health issues this lockdown period. There's a time na for 3 days, sobrang sakit ng wisdom tooth ko and wala akong access dun sa dentist ko, and yun, I have to bear with it. Tapos, there's a time na biglang sumakit yung paa ko for unknown reasons, diba? Tapos for 2 days, I couldn't walk properly. Plus, I got myself burned with the cooking oil. So, yun. So, for me ngayon, productivity just means just to make one video a week para sa akin. So, sorry for letting you down, but yun na lang muna yung kaya I'm going for my productivity. Other suggestions, inspirational books. So, before I go to the inspirational books, I made a video before about the top 3 books that influenced my life. So, yung una dun is yung Rich Dad, Poor Dad by Robert Kiyosaki. Then, pangalawa is yung How to Win Friends and Influence People by Dale Carnegie. So, ito yun. Next book that influenced my life is yung The Dip by Seth Godin. So, it's about quitting. Boom. So, with regards to inspirational books, so ito yung top 3 recommended inspirational books ko. So, una, ito, Think and Grow Rich by Napoleon Hill. Next is The Richest Man in Babylon. Then, yung last wala akong book na yun is yung Rich Dad, Poor Dad by Robert Kiyosaki. The next question I got is how to cope with stress or burnout. So, ito, I think everyone's different. So, parang hanapin mo kung ano yung what works for you. So, for me, what works for me is I surround myself with good people and I vent out my problems to them. So, ayun lang. I think that's what causes stress naman. Ito ba yung mga problema mo? So, for me, I just surround myself with good people who knows how to listen and kailangan kong i-stress out yung word na listen because in today's age, parang sobrang hirap makahanap ng mga kaibigan na marunong talagang makinig. So, if you have friends who knows how to listen, you have to be grateful for them. So, yun lang yung sa akin. I just surround myself with good people who knows how to listen. Ganun lang ako mag-deal with stress for me. For others, what I've heard is either mag-exercise sila, kumain sila, manood sila ng movie, they do what they are passionate about, either mag-video sila, mag-photography sila, or they paint. So, ayun, please let me know then how you deal with stress kasi ako mismo, I'm not really sure kasi feeling ko talaga, I mean, ito kasi preference-based to, so I want to know how others deal with stress so I could probably learn then something from you. So, ayun, please shoot them in the comment section down below how you deal with stress. What to do when you're uninspired or unmotivated? So, for me, meron akong tatlong sagot dito. Depende kung gaano ako uninspired or unmotivated because I really went through a lot of shit last year. So, I went through dark times. So, yun. So, una muna dito is I keep doing things kahit I'm unmotivated or uninspired. Siguro I cling to this phrase na what differentiates professionals from amateurs is that professionals do what they need to do with or without inspiration. So, yun. Parang I wanted to act professionally. So, keep doing things kahit hindi ako inspired or kahit hindi ako motivated. Tapos, minsan din naman, you have to do it first. Then, the inspiration or the motivation comes along. So, pwede din yun. So, yun yung unang scenario. The second scenario is I just type sa YouTube yung Living Life of Quiet Desperation. And nagpop up yung video ni Joe Rogan. And yung gist lang ng video na or yung clip na yun is that you have to work all your waking hours when you have the time and energy when you're in your 20s para ma-escape ka sa rat race or yung, alam mo yun, para makuha mo yung life na gusto mo. And pagka hindi mo yung ginawa, mag-lilit yung window mo, lilit yung window opportunity mo. So, yun, parang it motivates me na to use or to make what I can with the limited time or with the time that I have now habang may energy and time pa ako.
That most men live lives of quiet desperation. It's one of my favorite quotes ever because it's true. So and I've true. Been that guy.
Oh my God.
You're just in this world where you just can't wait to just run away.
And how do people get stuck there? How do you think they get stuck there?
Bills.
Bills, like financial
yeah.
bills?
Mm-hmm. Right? Yeah, that's bills and commitment. Well, the opportunity takes place usually when you're young and you don't have any responsibility. That's when you have your options. Well, your options are severely limited the more you gather
right.
responsibilities. Like if I had, as a 51-year-old father of 3, married man, pays taxes, has a house and a mortgage and a business and all that jazz. If I had to quit everything now and struggle the way I struggled as a stand-up comedian, it would never work. But the only way I could be this person now is if I took that chance when I was 21, when I was dead broke and had my cars repossessed and all that stuff. That's the only way you ever get where you want to go. You have to take a path that's dangerous. And most people want to take the safe path. And the safe path leaves you stuck in quiet desperation almost every time. It's hell.
Third scenario, if I'm really uninspired or unmotivated, I actually take a pause and take a break and reflect on why I have to do what I need to do. So, ayun, I do actually take a break then. So, when I pause, I reflect on why. bakit kailangan ko siyang gawin or bakit ko ba ito ginagawa. If I have a deep reason why, alam mo, parang eventually, babalik naman ulit yung inspiration mo. You just have to trust yung process or yung pause mo or yung break mo. Tapos yun, once that inspiration parang pops, kasi maramdaman mo naman yun eh. You just have to act on it kasi it comes and go, and if you let it go, you'll just get stuck kung nasaan ka. Last patch-up question is, experiences that changed my perspective in life. So this is the most interesting question that I really got. So I'm really grateful sa comments na to. So thank you, Joy, for sending these questions. So ito, I have 4 episodes in life where it changed my perspective in life. So una muna dun is when my girlfriend broke up with me a decade ago. So siguro what it taught me is that kahit naggawin mo yung best mo, there will be times na hindi mag-agree sa'yo yung mangyayari. So parang yun lang, hindi porket ginawa mo yung best mo, it will turn out the way you want it to be, and you just have to be parang cool and be fine na ganun talaga yung mangyayari. The second episode that changed my perspective in life was when I met my college professor, Sir Ebang. Siguro yung lesson dun was, if you're really passionate about something, or if something is really meant for you na you're passionate about, parang you'll be able to find a way to ignite yung passion mo back into something that you really love if talagang para sa'yo yun. And if it doesn't go back, it means hindi para sa'yo yun. Kasi ang nangyari nun is, I was an ACE student nun, tapos sobrang ayaw pumasok sa klase niya kasi namamahiya siya eh. So yun, I was really having so much anxiety pagka pumapasok ako sa klase niya. And natanggal niya yung passion ko for ECE, and I never find the way back to get that passion. So yun, yun yung lesson ko from him, and which I'm really grateful and thankful for, kasi if hindi nangyari yun, I wouldn't be here talking to you in front of my camera. Third episode was when I was able to start a t-shirt business with my college friends back in Mapua. Kasi yung perspective ko nun was kung ano lang sinasabi sa akin ng parents ko na you'll only be able to make money or make a living if you'll work for somebody else. And ewan ko, parang I could make money pala doing what I want without parang working for somebody else. Parang yun, it expands my perspective na pwede pala tong gantong mga bagay. And yun, it really expands my perspective in life. The fourth episode that changed my perspective in life is when my great-grandmother died. Guess what it taught me is to live more in the present and appreciate the now. Parang yun, parang live in the present and appreciate the now. Kasi, paano ba? Guess when you're young, you're too focused in sa ambitions and goals mo, and nagsasuffer tayo sa destination addiction na magiging masaya ka lang when you achieve what you wanted in life, and hindi ka masaya pagka wala ka pa dun. And yun, parang made me realize na you could not make it to the end, or you could not make it to the things that you want. Hindi dahil you fail, but because maybe life is too short. So yun lang, parang it made me think, and naging resolution ko for this 2020 is to live more in the present. That's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed this video and stay safe, everyone. I know hindi ito yung typical kong ginagawa, but ito feeling ko yung parang pinaka way ko of how I could really engage with you personally on this kind of level. So yun lang, if you like this segment, kasi gusto ko sana siyang gawing constant segment in this channel, parang once every month. So it's like an ask me anything. So yun lang, if you like it and gusto nyo itong i-consider ko as a segment in my channel, parang type in the comment section down below na AMA. So that's short for ask me anything. Lagay nyo yung question nyo under that phrase. So yun lang, that's it. Yun lang, please put that in the comment section if you really like this segment. I consider it if you really like it. So yun lang, quick reminder na lang, please don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to my channel if you appreciate this video. Alright, that's it. Bye-bye!